I've sacrificed everything searching for it. A world within a story. To me centuries ago, of a timeless power, infinite in knowledge, voracious in hunger, the entity, a realm so close to ours but always out of reach, until I found him, Frank Stone, my key. My killer. I am Augustine Lieber, and I'm about to change our worlds forever.
I'm assuming you're the night watchman here.
I am.
Or just you, covering the entire site?
Oh, no. I got help.
Where are they now? On duty?
Of a manner. Merlin just goes where he pleases.
Merlin?
My dog. Dope him and pincher. Best friend a fella could ask for. Loyal to the seventh horn sounds. Trust him more than I trust myself.
I need to ask you a few questions.
I'm yours to dispose of.
Can I have your name?
Thomas Jefferson Holt. Call me Tom.
Officer Sam Green. Tom, I want to talk to you about...
I know it about. That missing boy, right?
That's right.
You think he could be missing here?
This mill looks a big place.
Biggest in all Cedar Hills.
But that don't make no difference. Ain't no funny business going on around here. Not undermining Merlin's noses.
Are you sure? Sounds like a lot of ground to cover for just you and your dog.
It's a big job, yes, sir. But ain't it the magnitude of the labor that keeps a man alert and ready for action?
Have you noticed anything suspicious around the mill?
Tonight?
Tonight, last few nights, anything at all?
Nope, nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. Why, heck, you don't believe me, ask your boss.
My boss?
Sheriff Kosich.
Right. My boss.
He saw by last night asking about the exact same thing. And I told him the same thing I'm telling you. There's no way that boy could be here, and Merlin and me not know about it.
And what did the sheriff say?
Okay, Tom. Then he got back in his car and left.
Huh. So what you're telling me is nobody's actually checked the mill for any sign of the boy.
When you say nobody, does that include Merlin?
No, Tom, it does not. I'm talking human investigators only.
In that case, Sam, I find it hard to argue with your assessment.
Any objections if I take a look around the place?
No objections from me. Of course, everything's locked for the night.
It's not a problem.
There's Merlin, of course.
Of course.
If you see him, tell him I'm looking for him.
Thank you for your help, Tom.
Happy to oblige.
window. I can get in through there. Easy does it. Locked. That's hardcore. Hello? Anyone here? It's police. No!
Who's there?
Ugh, smells like death.
Hey, Mr. Green.
Officer.
Oh, yes, sir, of course. We haven't seen Merlin, have you?
No, yeah, sorry. Ugh.
You all right there?
Ugh. Yeah, it's just... Jesus, you don't smell that?
Sniffer's out of commission. Got a little too up close and personal with a can of mustard gas back in the trenches.
Ah.
It can be a blessing in disguise.
Ugh. Gotta find out where it's coming from.
What's it smell like?
Nothing good.
We wondered where you got to. Come here, boy! Dagnabbit! Sure would have liked it if you two made proper acquaintance.
God damn it. You put this out for him?
No.
It looks like someone else has found his way to your boy's heart. Through his stomach.
It ain't possible. Merlin and me, we're a team. Who'd want to come between a man and his best friend?
What's that? Some kind of wiener meat?
Will you look at that? That damn dog? Think that belongs to the boy you're looking for?
Nah. Came from someone much older. A teenager, maybe.
Jesus, married a milkmaid.
A
Hey, you know about any other folks going missing in Cedar Hills lately?
Well, I don't know. Who would know a thing like that?
Well, somebody does.
What was that sound? Stay behind me. So, what is this thing?
The Great?
Yeah, what is it for?
It's, for the furnace, I think.
You don't know for sure?
Yeah, I work at the mill, not in the mill.
Hmm. Gotcha. Stand back. All right. Take this. Use the radio in my car and call the station.
Where are you going? You really think that boy's down there?
I don't know. But I got a feeling, and it's not a good feeling. Hey. I'm gonna need you to take this, too. Make sure the sheriff gets this.
Oh, boy, I don't know.
I need your help here, Tom. I wouldn't ask if I didn't.
I just don't know if I'm made of the stuff, buddy.
They don't call it a higher calling for nothing. You gotta rise to meet it. You can do this.
Yeah, I can do this.
Hey, I'm counting on you, Tom Hope.
Maze down here. This has got to be it. This place turns my stomach. Things just get weirder and weirder down here. Goddamn small spaces.
Ah!
motherfucker.
This is right.
Thank you.
throne. I'm here. Everything's all right. Do this, Maddie. Just stay on the right side of the road. I mean the left. The left side is the right side.
The scaffold was high, and eternity was near.
Is that a hitchhiker? You need a lift?
Reynolds got a flat.
Oh, you're American.
Yeah.
So am I.
Okay. Yeah, so do you mind giving me a lift?
Right, sure, of course.
You can drop me off at Garrett Manor. It's just a few miles up the road.
Huh, weird. That's actually where I'm going, too.
So it's not out of your way?
Guess not. So we're both going to the same place, huh? What are the odds of that?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it's not all that odd, seeing as, you know, we're already pretty close, and I don't think this road goes anywhere else. So, did you say you were going to Garrett Manor for business, or...?
I did not.
Oh. So, where are you from?
From?
Like, where do you live?
Paris. That's where I'm from. Currently. Before that, I was from Amsterdam, Dublin, Milan, Los Angeles, and Oregon. Once upon a time.
That's cool. Hey, my mom's from Oregon. Well, one of them is. I always heard it was really nice. Or kind of a shithole, but like a really nice kind of shithole. I mean, I wouldn't know anyway because I've never been. I'm a Big Apple girl, born and raised. Barely even made it north of 14th Street before going off to college.
Here in England?
No, Berlin, actually. Oh, I'm Maddie, by the way.
Linda. It's nice to meet you, Maddie.
Yeah, you too. Even if I was worried you might try to clonk me.
Sorry.
Thank you.
So, what do you know about this manor we're both coincidentally going to?
What do you know about it?
Hold on now, that's not fair. I asked you first.
Okay, well, I don't know anything, and I'm guessing neither do you.
I didn't say I didn't know anything.
Yeah, you did.
You could tell.
Kinda, yeah.
All I know is that I was invited for a personal audience with Augustine Lieber, and that was supposed to be super fancy or something, and that it would be in my best interest not to turn it down. What?
My invitation was pretty much the same. Hey, take a look. I think we've come to the end of the rainbow.
This place is definitely a little too,
on the nose?
I was gonna say a little too much like a horror movie.
Exactly.
So, do we just knock, or...?
I'm not sure.
Oh! Doorbell. Maybe nobody's home.
This is definitely when I was told to get here.
Me too. Hello? Anybody home?
It's a good rule of thumb to try every door.
No, you think?
Well, they're expecting us, aren't they?
No way is it. Do we just go in?
Why are you asking me?
'Cause you're a grown-up.
So are you, Maddie.
Then, here we go. Apparently... Why are all the lights off?
Beats me.
Hello?
Let's take a look around.
Hello? We've arrived.
Huh. Well, even I could play this. Really digging these creepy cottage core vibes. Do you play? A little. Whoa. Crazy, right?
Yeah.
You've seen a real secret passage before?
It's fairly common for old mansions like these to have concealed corridors. To allow the servants to come and go while being seen as little as possible.
You got some of these in your house too, huh?
Secrecy is a privilege of the rich, stolen from the rights of the oppressed.
Okay. Kid must have had a creepy doll on their Christmas list. This seems a bit more lively. This is kind of freaking me out. It's weird, right?
Arriving at an abandoned mansion with no one to greet you? Yeah, it's a little odd.
Oh God. This is when some guy with a chainsaw rushes up from the basement, isn't it?